the Golden State squad coming through the tunnel earlier, with the Warriors faithful anxiously awaiting their arrival on the court. Welcome, everybody. Thanks for joining us for NBA action on 2K Sports. Brian Anderson here. With me, Grant Hill and Richard Jefferson. Joining us courtside is Allie LaForce. Allie, take it away.
Warriors head coach Steve Kerr last season was named the next head coach of the U.S. men's basketball team alongside Eric Spoelstra and Monty Williams. Kerr had served as an assistant under Greg Popovich, who led the team since 2015. Now the baton has been passed, and the sense is the team is in good hands.
All right, good stuff, Allie. Thanks. And a chance here to check out some stats for Klay Thompson.
And by looking at his true shooting percentage over the last five games, you can see how much he's paying attention to his shot selection, and it's showing.
A look at the opening lineup for the Orlando Magic. We've got Suggs. He's out there with Franz Wagner. Banchero out there with Wendell Carter. And it's Bol in at the four. And for the Warriors, the core of the dynasty all on the floor. Curry and Klay, the guards, with Draymond up front at the four. Andrew Wiggins is out there with Kevon Looney.
And you know, offense has been the problem for the Magic. Near the bottom of the league for several years now. Lack of efficiency for extended stretches.
So Golden State will get the first possession. Wiggins outside. Looney the screen. From 13. Shoots from 12. It's tipped. Pass to Suggs. Here's Banchero. Back to Suggs. 4-3. Pure from three-point range. And for the Magic, worst offensive rating in 2022.
Yeah, and the second worst rating in 2021 as well. It's an issue they have been trying to address. It's limited their ability to get back into the playoffs.
Now here's Curry. Wiggins for three. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Curry.
That's how you up the ante. Come right back at him.
Yeah, I love the competitive fire right there. You drain a triple on us, and I'm coming for my revenge.
Here's Banchero. An effective score for them, scoring around 21 and a half points a game. Carter can't get it to go. And the Warriors with possession. Thompson passes to Looney. And Looney with the slam.
The team first mentality of Thompson. When someone on his squad is open, he finds them.
Here's Suggs. He's covered by Curry. Pass to Banchero. And the layup falls.
He can play big and tough. I mean, Banchero bangs his way in.
And that was the mobile one drive. Low resistance to the finish line.
Yeah, aggressive take there to get inside. They're looking to make things happen to try and take control of this game.
Wagner against Thompson. Outside Curry. Now here's Looney. Stolen by Carter. Here we go. One-on-one. Pass to Banchero. Howard down after the assist led him to the lane.
And this is why you must push Banchero out of the paint, or else he'll slam it all over you.
Now Looney. Curry with it. There's the three. It's rebounded by Wagner.
And Franz Wagner, one of the surprises of the 2021 rookie class. He had a great rookie campaign, one of a handful of terrific rookies.
Out to a hot start. Four makes and five shots to begin this ball game.
Thompson finds Looney. Pass to Curry. Over Suggs. After missing his first attempt, now 1 for 2. And Wagner wasn't viewed as an exciting selection. He's been terrific, Grant.
B.A., you know, he finds ways to contribute each game. You knew he'd be a solid shooter out of the gate, but he also has a great touch in and around the paint to be a threat inside.
And there is the whistle. That'll go on Kevon Looney. That's his first foul of the game. Against Thompson. Here's Bull. Looking at his production. Close to 12 points a game. It's stolen by Looney.
That is how you deny entry. Great effort.
Here's Wiggins. Deflected. And there's two. Work on the glass pan off that time. Wiggins has got 5 now. The Magic have gone 4 of 5 so far. Looking sharp. We're just over 3.5 minutes into this first quarter. Pass to Suggs. Left side Carter. 6 on the shot clock. Pulls up at the elbow. Not going to go that time. So Golden State will take it the other way. Now Curry. A dangerous offensive player. His scoring average stands at almost 30 a game.
And that's when they say you can't teach tall. This is where size helps you, owning those rebounds on the defensive end.
Back to Wagner. Pass to Ben Carroll. Here's Suggs. Takes a 3. And once again, off the mark by Orlando. Outside, Green. On the wing, Curry lets the 3 fly. Bull grabs the board. Orlando's gone 1 for 3 from beyond the arc. And here's Wagner. Carter, a screen on Wiggins. Here's Wagner driving in. Count it. 1 for 1 to start the game.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
Yeah, as soon as these guys feel contact, they are just disappearing like they're not even there. You gotta show some fire and keep defending.
Time called here. The Warriors decide to talk it over. And it's a completely new group here for the Warriors. With the trade deadline approaching, RJ, rumor mill has been active. How does that affect a player when their names are being mentioned in trade rumors?
Well, it can be a blow to your confidence, and it makes it tough to trust the organization at times. And if players are well-liked, it can tear a locker room apart. I've seen it.
Now here's DiVincenzo. He's been productive, averaging just over 7 points a game. And again, it's the Warriors missing.
No clue how he misfired on that shot. You don't see that from him very often.
Anthony outside. Outside Ross. Wagner with a screen on Poole. Ross, count it. 1 for 1 to start the game. 1:31 left to play in the first. Poole outside. Orlando grabs the miss. Last game matched up with the Grizzlies. A tough loss there.
And the win was there for them, but they just let it get away. Just couldn't make enough plays late.
They played pretty solid basketball, but a few miscues is all it takes to turn a win into a loss, especially against a good team.
Shot clock at 6. That one doesn't drop, and Golden State will go the other way with it. Their last meeting was in Orlando, where they were unable to fight off the Magic.
And obviously, the whistles weren't in their favor the last time these teams met, and it cost them.
From beyond the arc, and then some.
Defensively, you have to stay connected to them on the perimeter.
Anthony outside. Wagner with a screen on DiVincenzo. Anthony, the pass to Wagner. And a miss there on the triple. The Warriors have gone 5 of 12 in this first quarter. Pass to Green. To the paint. Here's Wiseman, and it's Wiseman with the jam.
NBA, the one-hand dunk just looks so fluid.
Yeah, absolutely. Even smooth when he's powering it home like that. Here's Anthony. And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Warriors ahead. They're up by one. And we'll bring you the start of quarter number two when we return.
13.
Even matchup after this first quarter of play. And what do you guys think about the Warriors here in this one?
Well, clearly they played well in the first period because of their selfless attitude.
They're playing for one another and focusing on making winning plays. You love to see it.
Orlando trailing here. And Grant, so much young talent for the Warriors. Many said they should trade for veterans. They resisted.
And they won a title anyways. I mean, with the salary cap perhaps their greatest obstacle, having contributors on cost-controlled rookie contracts sure helps.
All right, this is how the floor looks for the Magic starting the second. We've got Banchero. Wagner is out there with Markel Fultz. Then it's Wendell Carter. And it's Bol in at the power forward position. Now here's Curry. Pass to Kuminga. Beyond the arc. And the Warriors with another three!
Just an unselfish play from Curry, always ready to move the ball and his body to help an open shooter.
Wagner outside. Now here's Carter. Here's Banchero. Back to Carter. It's stolen by Green. Outside. Quarter number two with just over a minute of play. Back to Green. And it's hammered home by Green.
And I like seeing Green go up for that flush, showing how powerful he can be.
Outside Fultz. Carter, a screen on Curry. Pass to Carter. Now Wagner. Just five on the clock. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play. All right, guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Warriors? And the Warriors make some changes. Looney's checked in for Wiseman. Wiggins comes in for Kuminga. And it's Thompson in for Poole. Suggs is checked in for Orlando. Falls for Carter. Well, as you know, Grant, this game can be so hard on your body. As a player, how do you determine the difference between being hurt versus being injured?
That's a great question, BA. Look, sometimes as players, you need someone to protect them from themselves. Today's game, the teams today are so smart about protecting players and preventing things from getting worse. But it really comes down to the players, the doctors, the team overall, just being smart and having a big picture about the injuries.
Takes the three. The rebound by Carter. The Magic shooting around 50% of the game so far. Pass to Fultz. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Defeated by Detroit in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind them.
It was almost like they looked stunned when the game slipped through their fingers. Being on the wrong end of an upset leads to a quiet ride home.
Yes, that's definitely one that they want back, but you can't dwell on mistakes in the NBA. They need to forget about it, and it's on to the next one.
The Magic have gone just 1 of 3 to begin the second quarter. Pass to Bol. And now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter here. Here's Suggs. He's got five. Shoots over Thompson. And the Magic, again, can't hit. And watching Draymond Green play, Grant, he's the quarterback on both ends.
I love that, B.A. Defensively, constantly calling out instructions on how to switch, keeping everyone organized. And offensively, Green is an incredible passer. Sees guys get open before they do.
Pass to Ben Carroll. Here's Bull from outside the arc. Counted from distance.
Already an excellent passer at his position. Ben Carroll just loves showing off his court vision.
Tried by Curry, and there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
And after winning MVP honors in 2015, Steph Curry was even better in 2016, taking home another MVP award going back to back.
That one's off. And that 2016 MVP year for Curry, Grant, one of the best regular seasons ever.
Oh, so true, B.A. Think about this. The Warriors winning an NBA record 73 games. Steph shattering the three-pointers made record over 400 for the season. Also leading the league in steals. Steph in 15-16, something else, guys.
Good on the second one.
Perhaps the greatest shooter the game has ever seen. Curry continues to age like fine wine.
Here's Suggs, defended by Thompson. Wagner outside from downtown. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. And after this one, they're at home against Phoenix. Anthony against Curry. Fires the three. Rebounded by Suggs.
He hasn't been able to find his touch this quarter.
Yeah, straight up, guys. Like, he's ice cold, like freezing. What's colder than cold? But you don't have to shoot it, my guy. It's okay to pass the ball.
Now here's Anthony. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Fires the three. No good on the shot. The Warriors leading. Outside Curry. Thompson outside. Jacks up a three. And the Warriors miss again. Orlando's gone 1-for-3 from downtown here in the second. Here's Suggs, defended by Thompson.
2 minutes remaining in the
Anthony
first
against Curry.
2 minutes.
And there's Bamba on the assist by Anthony. Bamba's got his first points of the night.
Oh, just an easy reverse for him. He has nice feel and touch around the bucket.
Curry passes to Wiggins. Oh, it's blocked by Bamba. Here's Suggs. 5 points in the game. Pass to Anthony. There's a minute 26 left to play in the half. Inside. Here's Wagner. And he makes no mistake. Slam dunk.
And plays like that one can make the difference in a close game.
And it definitely got the bench on their feet, too.
And you can feel the jolt of energy that he sent through his team. That is a huge boost in a tight game like this.
Now a timeout called by Golden State. And the players take this opportunity to get some Gatorade. Getting some fluids in you is so important during these timeouts. Get fresh, keep those batteries charged.
Yeah, without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a ball game. And that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have to be hydrated.
And the Warriors going with a whole new group out there. And a change for the Magic. Wagner's checked in for Suggs. There's a minute 12 left to play in the first half of basketball. Back to Wiseman. Pass to DiVincenzo. Outside Kuminga. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Personal foul.
Entering the NBA can be a difficult challenge, and age can add to that challenge. Jonathan Kuminga was just 19 years old when he stepped onto an NBA court.
right. Two shot.
That free throw, no good. That one misses.
One reason this game is so tight is because both teams are hitting the boards with reckless abandon.
Three-pointer, Anthony. Bamba controls the rebound and the putback.
Just great positioning to get the rebound, then get it back up.
Here is DiVincenzo. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Wiseman. Some solid defense from Bamba.
Well, you gotta miss sometimes, but that one seemed like a gimme.
27 seconds left to play in the first half. Now here's Wagner, coming off a 22-point game against Memphis. Five on the clock. From deep. And it's Wiseman with the rebound. Here's Moody. Down low. Wagner with a steal. And we're through the first half of play here in what's been a good one. It's the Magic leading by just two. And we'll be right back after halftime to get the third quarter on.
Hi, folks. It's shaping up to be a good second half as we've seen the Orlando Magic trying to take control of this game.
Everything going their way on the offensive end. Their stars are beasting, Shaq. Beasting. And I know you had a couple nights like that yourself.
I was on every night. Ernie, can you believe this guy?
No, I think he makes a very valid point.
No, remember 1995, Shaq?
Yeah, I remember that night.
Kareem Olajuwon.
Oh, okay, Kenny. Yeah, Kenny, you won one series. But you have two and I have four. So there's two more than you and four more than Ernie. So both of you, shut it up.
And now, let's focus on a couple of guys who have been getting it done in the first half.
They've each been fantastic tonight, playing with fire, doing just about everything. Lots of pressure on these two in the second half.
I remember being the guy on the given night. Well, for me, it was all nights.
And that's a wrap on halftime. Thanks for watching as we send you back to BA to call the second half.
In that first half, we'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during halftime. Orlando leading. The core of the dynasty all on the floor. Curry and Clay, the guards, with Draymond up front at the four. Kevon Looney is out there with Andrew Wiggins. And that's the group for Steve Kerr as we begin the second half.
A great move. I mean, the defense has no response.
Yeah, taking it right to the rim. What matches that might be discussed at halftime? That's going to be on the film.
Ooh, he dialed that one up from long distance. Thompson's gotten himself going with a triple, his first basket of the game. The former home of the Warriors, Richard, Oakland. What was it like to play over in the East Bay?
Listen, it was a lot more fun when I was playing in a Warriors uniform versus playing against them. Those crowds are insane. Maybe the loudest in the NBA, although the Boston fans might have a little bit of something to say about that. But I must say, this new building is gorgeous.
It's a close one here in San Francisco. To the paint. And it's hammered home by Green. We've seen five lead changes so far. Neither team able to pull away.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to come down to the wire.
Knocked loose. Here's Banchero. Banked it in off the glass.
Hello, Banchero.
Banchero's got six.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
The three from Curry. and the Warriors with another three.
A clean start to the half for them, knocking down their first three shots.
For Orlando, they've gotten two of four shots to go since the break. Pass to Bowl. Wagner up top, defended by Thompson. And here's Carter. Count it, and one! He'll have a chance at a three-point play.
Second personal foul.
Kevon Looney picks one up. All right, Richard, I was looking over your accomplishments, doing a little extra prep on you. An NBA title with the Cavs, a state title in high school, and almost won it all in college at Arizona. Is that the one what-if in your career?
Oh, no. Thank you for bringing those up. But, yeah, I have tons of what-ifs. I have, you know, obviously the college championship. I also got Athens in the 04. And, look, just for giggles, I also like to talk about the two times I lost in the NBA Finals going against Shaq and Kobe, then Tim Duncan, David Robinson, and Manu Ginobili. But the funny thing is, it's not like they didn't have Hall of Fame head coaches. It was only Phil Jackson and Greg Popovich. So, you know, I've run into a few buzzsaws in my day.
Wiggins outside. The three from Curry. That one is off. Now Orlando takes it the other way. Following this one, they hit the road to challenge the Kings at Golden One Center in Sacramento. That'll be just the second road game of five in a row. Here's Bancaro, hounded by Wiggins. Pass to Bowl. There's the triple. Warriors with the rebound. Outside Curry. Now here's Wiggins. Here's Thompson. Fires for three. It's rebounded by Bancaro. And we think back to 2015, Grant. Klay Thompson with the best quarter in league history.
Oh, B.A. 37 points from him in one quarter, setting an NBA record. Klay 13 for 13 from the field and 9 for 9 from deep, taking only four dribbles the entire time. Only Klay Thompson, guys.
And sometimes on defense, you can just get lucky.
Pass to Thompson. On the wing, Green. The three is up. And there's Thompson on the assist by Green. Thompson's got 6 points in the quarter.
They haven't looked the same on defense during this second half. Seems like they are relaxing and allowing them to get whatever shot they want.
Here's Bancaro, pounded by Wiggins. There's the double team with Wiggins. Bancaro. Here's Suggs. Clock at six. Pass to Bowl. The Magic need to put one up here. From deep. And it's Wagner missing. Golden State has got three of six threes to fall in the third quarter. The drive by Wiggins. Laid it in with a nice touch off the window. And now it's a five-point Warrior lead.
A mobile attacking player. Wiggins' teammates and coaches love when he uses his physical tools to his advantage.
And the Warriors will go with a different look here. Wiseman, he's checked in for Looney. Green comes in for Green. Kuminga, he's checked in for Andrew Wiggins. And it's Poole in for Thompson. A big group substitution here for Orlando. Bamba's checked in for Carter. Okiki comes in for Bowl. Ross, he's checked in for Wagner. And it's Fultz in for Suggs. Fultz finds Bamba. Here's Bancaro. Ooh, rejected by Wiseman. Curry against Fultz. Curry passes to Poole. Back to Curry. Oh, nice finish from the low block. That one's good. Curry's got 11 points.
And adding to this lead right now. Riding a wave of momentum.
Yeah, they've locked in during this stretch. If they keep it up, their lead will only continue to grow.
Here's Fultz. That one a little long. And the Warriors with possession. They're on a 15-4 run. Outside Curry. Screened by Wiseman. Nice work on the boards, paying off for the basket. And the Warriors lead by nine.
And their offense has been much tighter since halftime. Guys are starting to work together, moving the ball around, getting good shots.
Pass to Bancaro. uneasy, too, on the layup. Bancaro's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Oh, too big, too strong. It'll take more than that to stop Bancaro.
Well, I know you spent a lot of your career in Orlando. What are your favorite memories of that time?
None, B.A. You know I was hurt the entire time I was in Orlando. No, but in all seriousness, great people, great city, and it was fun to see young guys like Jameer Nelson and Dwight Howard get drafted and emerge as great players and leaders for their ball club.
Pass to Bamba. Gets it to go from the corner. And it's now only a 5-point Warrior lead.
And you can run offense through Bancaro time and time again. I mean, he is a special talent.
Green, the pass to Curry. Ross against Poole. Oh, a nice one-handed slam right there.
Now, that's how you use the screen right there.
And it leads to a thunderous finish. That was nice.
Yeah, you like the pick to set up the open shot. But when it leads to a dunk, okay, even better. You'll take it.
Bancaro, no good. A chance to go 2-for-1.
And you really must play this just right.
Here's Poole. Ooh, powered down with both hands.
Woo! Defensively, you can't afford to let him get to the rim that easily.
Well, that might be why their deficit is what it is right now.
Yeah, it's going to take better rim protection than that if they're going to climb out of this hole. Fantastic defense, giving full effort.
The Warriors leading. Pass to Curry. Kuminga with it. Robbed! From deep three-point range. And so it's the Golden State Warriors with a 9-point cushion at the end of the quarter. Their key to consistency has been their dominance in the paint. They've been the more physical team. More 2K action in just a moment. Let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
You know, I'm kind of stoked this was a choice because I love this pass. A remarkable find. He put his court vision on full display.
That wasn't a better pass in the game, almost like he had a sixth sense.
The fourth quarter has arrived. So good to have you with us.
This is where we need.
Well, the Warriors shooting 47% in this one. Looking efficient. Setting the floor for the Magic. In the backcourt, it's Anthony and Suggs. Then it's Wendell Carter. Then it's Franz Wagner. And it's Bowl in at the four-man position. Orlando trailing here. Pass to Suggs. Now Carter. Now here's Wagner. Hounded by Wiggins. And here's Anthony. Launches it. Sends it home from three-point land. Anthony's got his first 3 points of the game.
That's a guy you want taking shots. A quality offensive player.
Fires it. Offensive rebound. And that one's good. Wiseman. And the Warriors lead by 8.
Nice rebound. Trying to match the other team's intensity right now.
Pass to Carter. Three-pointer. He buries it from three.
That's exactly the kind of shooting you need down the stretch to win games.
The Warriors have gotten just one shot to fall out of three attempts in the fourth. Now here's Wiseman. Poole outside. Wiggins with it. Shot clock at 5. The three ball. That shot missing. And Orlando the other way now. Anthony outside. Carter, a screen on Poole. Pass to Carter. Here's Suggs. Back to Carter. Good work defensively by Wiseman. Green against Anthony. Now Poole. This one for 3. Connects from downtown.
Something he's worked on over the years. Green is an elite passer.
Orlando has gone 2 of 2 from outside so far in the fourth. Pass to Carter. Wagner with it. Here's Suggs. Anthony in the post, guarded by Poole. Wagner, the pass to Anthony. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. The Warriors have gone 2 of 5 from the field in this final quarter. Poole finds Thompson. Another three for Golden State.
And when it comes to the three, they've been really dialed in here in the second half.
The Magic shooting only 42%. Here's Suggs. Anthony outside. For three. And another miss by Orlando.
Just an ugly show from him offensively. Yep, no way to describe it. Just ugly, and that hasn't helped.
Here's Green. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
First personal foul.
So much to say about Draymond's game. Tough to say anyone else in the league has a larger impact on their team on both sides of the floor.
Taking two shots.
And he can't get the first one. And Richard, the weight that Draymond carries for this team can't be forgotten.
The impact he has on the defense alone is remarkable. But then you factor in the offense ability, bringing the ball up the floor. There is no doubt he is the vocal leader and the heartbeat.
Looney's checked in for the Warriors. DiVincenzo comes in for Poole. And he sinks the second.
And with their title last season, the Warriors now with 7 in franchise history, no longer tied with the Bulls. They are alone and ranked 3rd all time.
DiVincenzo against Anthony. Here's Bull. And that one hits the back iron. The Warriors have got 3 of 6 shots to go in this fourth quarter. Anthony against DiVincenzo. To Thompson. The three nails it from beyond the arc. Thompson's got 12 points in just the second half, and the Warriors still have a long way to go to surpass the Celtics and the Lakers for total championships, each with 17.
But their ambition from the top down is to do exactly that. They want to be, in their own words, the greatest organization on earth.
Definitely playing the long game. And Carroll's checked in for Harris. And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Hi, guys. Well, Jamal Mosley was just reviewing the plan with his team. He did everything he could to fire the team up, saying, quote, "I don't care how far down we are, we can do this. Attack and take what's ours. Let's go out there and show them it's not over."
Thank you for that, Allie. Carter against DiVincenzo. Looney inside. Thompson against Anthony. Golden State needs to get off a shot. Nice shot by DiVincenzo.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. 4 of the last 5 buckets have been threes.
Anthony in the post. DiVincenzo covering. Outside Carter. Wagner, the pass to Anthony. And here's Carter. Pass to Bancaro. Looking to end the drought. And it's Wagner missing.
It's obvious they're becoming frustrated. Nothing seems to be going their way.
In a major drought, need to find some sort of momentum.
Count it. And the Warriors lead by 20.
They have a relentless mentality, even with the game in total control.
No let up with these guys. They're going for the throw now.
Orlando calls timeout. They're trailing by 20. There's 1:54 left in the fourth quarter here. And the Warriors making a switch here. Curry's checked in.
Stephen Curry.
Pass to Bancaro.
Get there, get there.
and the NBA last season introducing a 100-camera system that allows for a video game-like presentation with virtual angles. It's pretty cool. Video games used to chase the league. Now the league's kind of chasing the video games.
Yeah, well, this is where the future is heading. It is so cool to see all the different angles that you can now see a basketball game from. That's what makes it fun. That's what makes it exciting. And the NBA, they're doing the right thing.
And I know scouting departments are using them as evaluation tools as well.
Oh, they're always going to figure out a way to scout more and to evaluate more because it helps them when they're negotiating players' contracts.
Carter finds Anthony. Back to Carter. Here's the three. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. They led the game at one point by 20.
They came out and had a statement win with their performance tonight. A fantastic effort to get it done here for the Warriors.
They had to fight for this one. With the game hanging in the balance a couple of times, they made winning plays, Grant.
It's all about having a strong mentality. What's interesting is that anytime momentum turned against them, instead of folding, they responded with their own attack.
And they really wanted this one. It pushes their win total up to 21.
And this team really wanted to at least split this season series.
And as most people predicted, the defense, even though they were keying on him, had no answers for Klay Thompson.
We certainly got to see his best effort on offense, attacking the defense without fear and grabbing a lot of buckets.
Orlando out of bounds. Ball. It'll be Orlando's ball.
Substitution on the court.
Seconds left to play in the fourth quarter of this one. Pass to Okiki. Now Harris. Back to Okiki. It's Ross on the wing. Shoots over Kuminga. No good. And so Golden State takes this one, and by a big margin. Boy, they were something special to watch tonight, and the crowd loving every second of it.
It's always a great feeling when you play this well for your fans. This team really showed
again,
what it's capable of.
Thank you to everyone for coming.
All right, now let's check in with Allie LaForce. Allie, what do you have?
Look forward to seeing you at our next event.
I'm here now with Klay Thompson, and Klay, congratulations on the win. How satisfying is it winning games in front of this devoted crowd?
Well, we always want to put on a show for our fans. They deserve it. They show up every single night. And it's just fun to protect home court.
It's one of the best places to play in the league, no doubt. Thanks, Klay.
Thanks, Allie. Great interview once again. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Brian Anderson saying thanks for watching. Now our New Balance player of the game, Klay Thompson.